Dear friends, soon Ganesha Jayanti is going to come and we will do wonderful puja to Lord Ganesha. According to Ganesh Purana, Garuda Purana and Shiva Purana, Ganesh is a son of Shiva and Parvati. And the whole Puranic stories are very intimately connected to our life. So Ganesh is a son of Shiva. Shiva is super consciousness. Shiva is holy, sacred. Shiva is universal awareness. And his son is a universal mind. Because the very name Ganesha, Ga means senses, the doors of perception. Na means awareness. And Isha means God. So God of sensory perception, the God of sensory awareness, the God of universal mind, Vibhu mind is Ganesha. And Ganesh is called Parabrahma, Brahmanaspati. Everything is Brahma. Food is Brahma, which is awareness. Prana is Brahma, which is awareness. Mano iti Brahma. Annam Brahmeti Vyajanat, Prano Brahmeti Vyajanat, Mano Brahmeti Vyajanat. Means we will realize that there is a pure awareness in the food, in the prana, in the mind. And all these awareness, the Supreme Lord is Brahmanaspati, which is Ganesh. So Ganesh is intimately connected to your self-identified consciousness. So Jiva is Ganesh and Shiva is Lord Shiva. And when Jiva Shiva meet together, that moment Ganesh comes. So Ganesh is a son of Parvati, but it is ayoni sambhava, means he was not born to the birth canal. When she was taking bath and she was just applying some herbal paste, chandan, agaru, as well as so many other herbs, and she was doing this, and suddenly Lord Shiva entered into her bathroom and she was shy, she was closing her body. Then she thought that she needs some body to protect her room, privacy. So she created beautiful statue of a baby. And she looked at the statue with great love. She is a Parvati, she is a divine mother, she is a Prakriti. And suddenly life entered and that baby become alive. And then she called him, "You are Kumara, you are my son. Please take care of my door, nobody should enter." This is a very interesting story. And again Lord Shiva forgot something, he again came. So this baby, Kumar, he stood there with a danda, punishing cane. And he said, "No sir, you cannot go inside." So Shiva asked him, "Who are you?" He said, "I am a son of Parvati. My mother is taking bath and you are not supposed to enter without her permission." No. And there was argument and the whole become a war, and then war happened between all the army of Lord Shiva, army of Lord Vishnu, and it was difficult to conquer that boy because he had incredible energy. He defeated in that battlefield everyone. And Parvati was taking bath and outside war was happening. Can you imagine that? This is a very cute little story. But then it was very difficult. In that war, Lord Shiva chopped the head of that baby. And baby cried, "Ma!" and fall down. Parvati heard that sound of her baby. She came out and she said, "Who killed my son? I will destroy all gods and all devas and devi, deviti and all these. I can destroy all three worlds, swargam, mrityu, patal, everything. I will call Kali, I will call Durga." Because Durga Kali is her own aspect. Then everybody, they saw the divine mother's wild form. All gods and deity, they surrender. They say, "Oh Ma, forgive us. Our intention is not to kill your son. Put life back into my son." But the head is gone. So then Lord Shiva sent Indra to find somebody's head to put it there. And there was a cute little baby elephant. He's a son of Airavat. Airavat was a big elephant of Lord Indra. And this Airavat's son was meditating, sitting quiet. And they saw that he entered into samadhi. So they chop his head, and that head is brought. And they have done plastic surgery, and they put the head on the body of the baby. That's why Ganesh has a cute little body of a baby, but head of an elephant. Now, elephant head and human body looks weird. It is not weird. It has a great esoteric meaning. Head is chopped, means ahankar is gone. Head is a symbol of ahankar, ego is gone. Then they put the head of the elephant. So that is the picture of Om. Om has typical omkaraha, gajakaraha. Gaja means elephant, the trunk of the elephant is like the matra of Om. Akar, ukar, makar. Akar is Brahma, ukar is Vishnu, makar is Mahadev. All these three gods are there. So symbolically, Ganesh is a symbolical expression of first cosmic soundless sound, Om. Therefore, Ganesh is the God of all God, Om. Because in the embodiment of Lord Ganesha, Akar is Lord Brahma, the creator. In the Ukar, Lord Vishnu, the sustainer. And in Makar, Lord Mahadev, who destroys everything. So, symbolically, Ganesh is an embodiment of Om, and Om is an embodiment of Ganesh. Therefore, Saint Dhyaneshwar, he described Ganesham. Om Namo Jiyadya Veda Pratipadya Jaya Jaya Swasam Vedya Atma Rupa Devatuchi Ganeshu Mane Nivruti Dasu. Oh boy, this is amazing. The meaning of this is so, goosebumps happen on my body. Akar Charana Yugalu. Akar is the Charana Yugalu, the two legs, folded legs is Akar. Ukar Udara Vishar. Ukar is the big belly. And Ganesha's belly is so big. In the belly of Lord Ganesha, there are billions and trillions of galaxies. Can you imagine how big the Ganesh is? Makar Mahamandala Mastakakare. So Akar Charana Yugalu, Ukar Udara Vishar, Makar Mahamandala Mastakakare. This very expression is Lord Ganesha. Om Namo Jiyadya. Veda Pratipadya, I salute to that Om. The Veda try to explain what Om is, Veda Pratipadya, Jai Jai Swasam Vedya. Oh my God, that Ganesh is Swasamvedya. Swasamvedya means self-knowing. Self-knowing is Ganesh. And there is Swasamvedya means only your consciousness knows itself. Mind cannot know itself. Body cannot know itself, prana cannot know itself. Who is there, swasamvedya, who can understand oneself as one is? That is your daily operating consciousness. So your daily operating consciousness is Ganesha. Om Namo Jiyadya Veda Pratipadya Jai Jai Swasamvedya Atma Rupa. Oh boy, your Atma, your soul, your spirit, your pure awareness knows itself. This is the very beautiful description done by Sant Ganeshwar, in the first line of the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita, as a translated as Ganeshwari or Bhavartha Deepika, this is very profound. So Ganesh is your soul. Ganesh is your Atman. Om Namo Jayadya Veda Pratipadya Jaya Jaya Swasam Vedya Atmarupa. Your self Atmarup is Ganesh. Deva Tuchi Ganeshu Sakala Mati Prakashu. Means you can give, Mati means Buddhi. O Lord Atman Ganesha, you give inner light, inner glory, insight, and you can give supreme intelligence. So Atma, the self, the pure Atman, is that Lord Ganesha who gives us Mati. Mati means Buddhi, the reasoning capacity, the faculty of recognition, the faculty of knowing, and faculty of retaining the information. So Ganesh is universal. Ganesh is everywhere. Any living creature has Ganesha in the form of pure consciousness. So this Ganesha, though he came as a son of Shiva and Parvati, but he is Supreme Lord. He is the first Lord to be worshipped according to ancient Veda. And Ganesh Upanishad is Ganapati Atharva Shirsha. Shirsha means head. Tharva means chanchala, means buddhi is chanchala, mobile, unstable. Unstable, chanchala, buddhi becomes stable because of Ganesha. So Ganapati Atharva Shirsha. It is a head of all sutra, of all Upanishad, which if you daily chant Atharva Shirsha, your mind will become stable, your buddhi will become stable, and you will attain samadhi, the equilibrium, the trance of equilibrium, where there is a bliss, beauty, that is Satchidananda. Sat Chid Ananda. Sat is truth, Chid is awareness, Ananda is bliss. This is the form of Atma Ganesha. So, Ganesh Chaturthi is there. We will perform puja. Puja is outer symbolic. Sumana, flower, is your mind. Dhupa is your breath. And you are offering water, which is your rasadhatu, plasma. You are offering panchamruta, that is milk, yogurt, ghee, sugar and honey. This panchamruta is symbolically connected to the rasarakta mamsamed asti dhatu, and it will offer. So puja on physical level is happening in physical term, in physical level. Then puja become internal on mental level, on psychological level, in psychological term, in psychological state. And then it will lead you to the spiritual level, in spiritual term, in spiritual awakening. Word puja come from puja. Puja means holy, puja means sacred, and puja means zero. Zero you can draw clockwise or counterclockwise. There is a starting point and you go back and come back to the origin. So puja means to go back to the source, go back to the origin and complete the circle of awareness. So in this satsang, Ganesh Puja means Atma Puja. Ganesh Bhakti is Atma Bhakti. And therefore, by doing this Ganesh Puja, even you can do Manas Puja. You can say, I am inviting Lord Ganesha to sit in my heart. My heart is the place where Lord Ganesha is sitting. Then I am offering him water to clean his feet, to welcome his. That is called padya. I am offering him water to take achaman, to rinse the mouth. I am giving little bath with water to clean his body. This is all mental thing. Then I am offering Lord Ganesha some chandana, haridra kumkumam, turmeric and red kumkum. I am offering Ganesha the dhupa of my breath. I am offering Ganesha, flower of my innocent mind. And I am offering Ganesha the namaskaram, the prarthana. And I am offering Ganesha the fruit, the prasad. And then this fruit is the fruit of your positive will, Ichha Shakti, Jnana Shakti, Kriya Shakti. And this fruit will bring fruitfulness into the life. So you can do puja outwardly, you can do puja inwardly. And then finally you say, Tvameva Mata Chapita Tvameva, Tvameva Bandhu Chasakha Tvameva, Tvameva Vidya Dravinam Tvameva, Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva. Oh Lord Ganesha, you are my mom, you are my dad, you are my brother, you are my sister, you are my friend, you are my knowledge, you are my learning. Then you completely surrender to your Atman. And this puja, though it is done externally with this instrument, it will become internalizing puja by inner equipment, offering breath, offering mind, offering buddhi, and offering complete surrender to yourself. This is very beautiful puja, and if we do that, it will bring radical change, radical transformation, radical mutation in your psyche. So this kind of satsanga is absolutely necessary. Because Atman cannot be seen. And your mind cannot be seen. Your breath cannot be seen. So this is unseen scenery inside. But outside, Ganesha statue is visible. The flowers are visible. Then incense is visible. So it is a journey from visibility into invisibility. This is the journey from seen to the unseen. And that is why Nirgun, Nirakar, Nirvair, that inner state is Lord Ganesha. That is Ek Omkar hai. Nirvair, Nirakar. That is Sat Sri Akal. That is the Sat, the truth, Sri, the holy. And Sat Sri Akal. Akal means beyond time. So this is wonderful. Guru Nanak did this puja. And you will see that this puja is biological need, spiritual awakening for every human being. So dear friend, we will do this puja and share together. Namaste.